I am so proud. I am very, very proud of the black people in Chicago. They are now waking up and they are seeing the writing on the wall as a Democratic Party. As I've been saying for a long time, black politicians ain't shit. They are seeing that this is a direct attack by the Democratic Party on the very group of people in the United States that votes as a bloc for them. They are waking up now and they are seeing it. Welcome, 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 you guys. My name is Donovan Sabine. A lot to talk about. A lot has been happening in the public eye. And people are fed up at this point. People are fed up. I had to shut people down yesterday on my platform as I am getting sick and tired of people complaining about the inflation, food prices, gas prices, everything is going up, lack of jobs, AI, all of this other stuff. It's just amazing to me that the very people that are complaining about all of these issues, all to my knowledge, have voted and are registered Democrats. Where is Kamala Harris? Where is Tanji Brown? All this symbolism that we've been telling you guys. This is what they're feeding you, symbolism. Symbolism doesn't pay your bills. Symbolism does not feed your children. And now they're starting to see. Now, I live in California. I'm on a border state. A lot of the resources go to illegal migrants. As a matter of fact, I believe January 1st, the health care that we have, the Obamacare, the ADA Act, is now going to be available to undocumented people here in the United States. People that break our very laws get to benefit from a system that they do not put into. How does that make sense? Where in the hell are we getting these thoughts? Show me a country other than the United States where you can break their laws, go into their countries, use their resources, steal their jobs, and everything is okay. I would like to go to a country that I can do that. I show up illegally and I say, I'm here to steal your job. I'm here. Give me the benefits. I didn't put into it, but give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, give me. That's where we're at here in the United States. But black people are pushing back and they are now realizing that bullshit about vote blue no matter who and all this other crap that they have not been doing for us in over 60 years. The facts are the facts, people. The facts are the facts. Again, I'm going to tell you guys, wake up. Wake up. The bell is ringing. A big shout out to my fellow onliner, Philip Scott. He put out a great, great program last night on his podcast, highlighting the black pushback and what they actually do want and how they're going to go about getting it. If you go to my platforms, I also put the video up, and I again, the African Diaspora News Channel, Philip Scott is the source of the video that I equally shared. So black people, what do we do now? We told you Boulay Martin, he isn't delivering like he's supposed to. And now all of a sudden he's talking about he's going to have to start cutting shows. He's not delivering the black vote like he used to because people are fed up. They are seeing we are voting, voting, voting for our own demise, and the Democratic Party does not give a damn. This is not a Brandon Johnson problem. This is a Democratic problem. Brandon Johnson is a Democrat first. He is not a black man. He is a Democrat. All of these bootlegs, that's what they are. In my home state of California, Maxine Waters, she puts out these stupid ass tweets like she's engaged in what is going on. This woman is a woman of the silent generation. She's not even a baby boomer. She's a silent generation, and she's still in office. Talking to some people the other day, they were saying basically, well, what do we do? You know, I don't, I can't vote for Trump. Yeah, I, you know, Biden is too old. Both of these people are too old. Well, I told them, I said, well, it's a simple thing. Then you just don't vote. You don't vote for the president. You go, you know, go down the ballot and vote for something else. Vote your interests. If you guys haven't seen the video of these black protesters, they were hitting on some topics that Brother Phil Scott, Demetra K, myself, and a lot of others have. Tamara Sheely Johnson. I mean, we can go on and on and on about the people who've been ringing the alarm. And they were hitting topics that, to me, if you've been paying attention, is common sense. These are common sense things that you should have been doing. If you open your front door and you live in a hellhole or you live in a post-apocalyptic neighborhood, it looks like what's going on in Gaza right now. Why do you still re-elect the very people that are responsible for that area? I'm just happy that people are waking up, and I'm not going to be getting upset anymore. You know, I mean, I'm sitting here and I'm railing and stuff. The fact that I and others have been vindicated in what we've been saying, we've been showing it to you right in your faces. I mean, what is it that we had to do to wake you guys up? Pull our pants down and show you our junk or show you our asses to show you that there is no way in hell you can tell me that the Democratic Party has done anything specific to black people since the 1960s. That's over 60 years ago. Now people are seeing it. All of my Boule black friends that went to the HBCUs, they're silent. They're all silent. You know why? Because they don't have a leg to stand on. They can't talk about vote blue no matter who. Oh, the Republicans are going to put you in chains. And again, a lot of us that have been ringing the alarm, we're not Republicans because we are aware white supremacy, no matter what party you identify with, is white supremacy. The Republicans are no better than the Democrats, except that the Republicans are upfront with their racism. Here you are, black people, listening to these people talk about, well, if you get us in and you elect us, we're going to get rid of qualified immunity. What happened to that? We delivered them the House, the Senate, and the presidency. And everybody got a bag but black people. Right now, we have been supporting Israel since its inception. And unilaterally, all this money goes to Ukraine and all this other stuff, but they never have any money for reparations. And you know, the funny thing is, some of my white friends, they are now seeing the hypocrisy and the ludicrousness of how we could have money to fund wars and to fund illegals and to fund corporations, bail out Wall Street and all this other stuff. But we do not have money for the very citizens that are born and raised in this country. I'm a veteran, and I tell you guys that all the time. And I'm proud to be a veteran. Not everybody can serve in the military. Not everybody can put service before self. Not making any excuses for anybody else, but some people are so bad off in this damn country that it's survival of the fittest. And I get it. And I get it. They're skeptical and all this other stuff, and they got to make their own decisions. But it is a national disgrace when you see almost a million homeless veterans on the streets, homeless, but you could let people come into this country that these vets fought for to uphold the Constitution and to defend our borders. And you let these people come in willy. Now, gotta remember, it ain't the Republicans that are letting these people come in. It's the Democratic Party. And the reason why we talk about the Democratic Party is because overwhelmingly 96% of Black people vote Democrat. So there's no point in talking about the Republican Party. There's just no point in it. It's just a waste. It's a waste of breath. Okay. The Democrats are doing this. This is a direct attack on the Black community. And the people of Chicago are seeing it. Now in New York, Eric Adams is now advocating and giving tickets to migrants anywhere they want to fly. The city of New York is going to pay for it. We can't even pay for our own citizens to go on nice vacations and for the city to pay for it. Oh, how dare we? That's the tax dollar. But see how willy-nilly they can just take your money and dole it out for everybody. They can solve these problems unless you're an American citizen. Now, as Black people, we are seeing with the limited jobs that they do have here, they're bringing in people that are going to do those jobs. Damn the laws. Damn the laws. This is what they're going to do. Is it too late? That's my question. Have we woken up too late, Black people? Can we come back from this? I've said on my podcast several times, for Black people in this country, we are on the 5-yard line. It is the fourth quarter. There is 5 seconds left. And we need to score a touchdown plus a 2-point conversion just to tie, to get to overtime. And hopefully, if we can get to overtime, we can turn this thing around. As I looked at the video of the Black Chicagoans demanding what they want and what is going to happen, I noticed that the Black men did not speak. Fellas, we're men. Why are the ladies taking the forefront? Where are the older men in the community that are going to stand up and fight for the community? We know the women are going to stand up and do that because a community only goes as so far as the woman goes. We know that. We need the men to stand up and make a statement and say, we're not taking this shit no more. It's bad enough that Brandon Johnson, who is representing the Democratic Party, is bowing to the Democratic wishes and not standing up as a Black man for what is right. For what is right. And I'm going to tell Black people all over the nation, stop apologizing for being a Black citizen. You do not have to tell people you are anti-migrant. You don't have to say that. Your actions show if you are anti-migrant. You are pro-Black. When I hear you guys speak, I don't listen to you and say, wow, they sure sound anti-migrant. No, you sound common sense. You are speaking up for your people. You're speaking up for yourself. How the hell does that sound like you're anti-migrant? If people out here view your speak as anti-migrant, so be it. We need to start being unapologetic. Unapologetic about our stance. Unapologetic about our demands. We don't care who likes it and who doesn't. You don't see them being apologetic about how they are, how they're coming out here and breaking our laws. They're not unapologetic about it. As a matter of fact, as I speak right now, there is a sixth wave of migrants working their way up to the United States right now as we speak. I don't see them being unapologetic. The Democratic Party, led by Joe Biden, has legalized almost, I think it was, what, half a million Venezuelans to give them status here in the United States. That's not the Republican Party doing that. That's the Democratic Party. We are at war. We are at war with the Democratic Party. Or better yet, they are at war with us. the days of turning the other cheek and we gonna be nonviolent, you know, we marched with Martin Luther King, that worked in its day. That was 60 years ago. It's a new day now. You have to meet your opponent at the rules at which the game is being played today. You cannot play NFL football today based on rules of the 1960s. The game has evolved. So has petitioning your government and how you go about petitioning your government. As long as the white man, Republican or Democrat, knows that you're going to be nonviolent and you're going to be peaceful and you're just going to shout and march and do all that, they're not worried about you. They're not. Okay, well, what are they doing out there? Are you know, with their marching? Oh, okay, that's good. As long as they're not being violent, you know, we ain't got nothing to worry about. We're good. And I'm not telling you guys be violent. I'm telling you guys be direct, be unapologetic, be in demand. Why did it take 60 years for Black people to realize you have to demand what you want and mean what you say and say what you mean? But in the Black neighborhood for 60 years, we've been hearing stuff like this. Machine gun fire. We're living in Beirut. Why does it take the fact that there's absolutely nothing left? Absolutely nothing left when 50% of the homeless in the United States are Black people that we now realize we are in a trap? It's do or die. Why is it it took 60 years for that to happen? I'm going to tell you guys this. Is it too late for the Black community to turn this around? I don't know, you guys, but I am going to say this. Whatever the outcome, and I know a lot of you Black women push back against my toxic male activity, you know, but you know, the funny thing is my toxic male behavior is what attracts a lot of women to me. And I'm not going to apologize for being what I was created to be, a man. But my male toxicity, it's funny how you can call that out. But with all of these female leaders who have children that are being, they see other women's children being shot and murdered on the streets, you have no opinion and no voice when it comes to talking about their motherly female instinct of compassion and outright, when women, you know, nurturing. You have no voice for that. No voice. All of these so-called elected Black women, Kamala Harris, in these positions that do absolutely nothing but give you lip service, it is silence. But male toxicity must be addressed. Maybe we need more male toxicity in the world to turn this thing around, because we've tried it power sharing with women, and it's just destroying our community. It's destroying our community. Is it too late? We got 5 seconds. We're on the fourth down. We've got to make this conversion. We've got to score this touchdown, Black people, or it's just curtains. Big ups to the people in Chicago. I hope it's not too late. Donovan City, Reverend Democrat, Rehab Radio.